Joy Agwu is the permanent representative of Nigeria to the United Nations, and she joins me now here in New York. Joy, thank you so much for being with us. This is clearly 100 days on, taking such a toll on this local community.
Yes, Maggie, before I take that question, I would like to preface this conversation by letting the world understand that terrorism is a global problem that requires global solutions. Indeed, it is a threat not only to national, but to regional and international peace and security. That is why the UN is fully involved. And I think that this 100 days is not only a time for reflection, but I believe that we should use the momentum of this sympathy, not only for the children who were captured, for their parents, some have lost their lives, but we should use the momentum to go forward. As I told you earlier, it's a global problem. Many countries have pledged to help Nigeria. Many countries are indeed in Nigeria, helping to strategize to find the best way of recovering these children alive and intact, instead of a military option. The strategy has widened to include negotiations, dialogue with these people. So I believe that it is time to move forward, really, to find a solution to this problem, to find the girls first and foremost.
Absolutely.
Because
I think that's what
the country
world
is traumatized.
I think the world wants to see that.
Exactly.
The problem is many experts worry the longer this goes on, the less chance you will have of recovering these girls for their family. And Boko Haram seems to be operating at will. If there are negotiations going on, why are we seeing attacks and more people die?
Well, let me say that this is not the first time in history, in the history of hostage taking or abduction or kidnapping, that people have been kept for so long. It is traumatizing for all of us, not only for Nigerians, but for all the citizens of the world. This is where you see the manifestation of agony, keeping vigils and protests everywhere to see that these girls are released. They're appealing to the conscience of those who are holding these young children against their will. So I believe that it's time for us to get together in a concerted action. In the UN, I am Nigeria's representative to the United Nations. And I remember I made a statement the first time that there was this terror, the UN building in Abuja was bombed. I noted and I stated very unequivocally that violence, suicide, is not in the character of the Nigerian. This is an alien culture that is getting pervasive in our system. It is an external influence, and it is important to work concertedly with all nations to make sure that it is not implanted in our culture. We forbid suicide as a people. People who commit suicide are not given a decent burial. So what indoctrination is that that persuades a young person named a terrorist to strap himself and bomb people or to abduct children? This is an alien indoctrination. And part of the strategy to deal with it is to de-radicalize these people. They must be de-radicalized to become normal people again.
Well, certainly the challenge of our time. We thank you for coming in and talking to us about it. And we continue to hold those girls and their families in our thoughts. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Maggie.